My name's Merrick Thompson and I'm the Youth Work Team Leader for Beehive Project. Most of my time is spent at the Beehive, which is a local youth club. Weekly, yeah. We open every Thursday and Friday night between 5 and 9 and on a Saturday between 11 and 3. The Beehive is a traditional youth club, which means that the doors open to anybody that wants to come in, and during the opening times young people can get involved in different sorts of activities.
What kind of activities are there?
During session time, the young people get to play pool, they can hang out, talk with friends, they can buy food, do games, arts and crafts, what they want to do. It's very much youth-led. A lot of youth clubs that I've been to have had a structure, so at 5 o'clock this happens, that happens. And my experience, I've found that young people feel as though they can't come in if they don't want to do the activity at that time. So we don't really structure anything. I know what's going to happen that night, but I don't necessarily write it down and tell them there's going to be a timetable, because that's a little bit like school as well, which young people tend not to do. Well, the film club is probably the biggest venture that we have just now, the project that a lot of my time has been spent on. The film club runs weekly on a Friday night for 3 hours. During that time they take part in quizzes, watch movies, but what's happened is because of the enthusiasm of the club, they've started to make their own films, they've started to get a lot more involved in other local opportunities, and they work with those, the Berwick Film Festival, ITV, on specific projects around media, young people, and all other types of visual arts. So for example, this year we'll make a film for the film festival, which will be shown during the big launch over in September.
What type of people come here already?
At the Beehive we have quite a varied group of young people, aged between 12 and 25. Everybody's welcome, it doesn't matter what age you are. Activities are done through a sort of age-appropriate kind of way. So if a 12-year-old is here and a 19-year-old here, we make sure that we do things that both groups can enjoy and take part in. All sorts of young people come in. There's people that come in and just want to play pool. They just want to catch up with staff and perhaps talk about things that are important in their lives at that moment. Or we have young people who come in for opportunities such as the film club and want to take part in something specific. So all sorts of young people can come in to do whatever they want. We do have quite a strict code of conduct in the Beehive. We have to, otherwise there would be anarchy. So the only rules are that young people don't use inappropriate language or inappropriate behaviour, there's no violence, we have zero tolerance to any sort of bullying, that sort of thing. The type of young people that we're here for is basically anybody that needs us. A lot of young people locally can become quite isolated, we're a small town, there's not much to do, and for those young people who don't have an interest, so they're not taking part in sports, taking part in local drama or theatre productions, or they have nothing to do, then this is the place for them. This is somewhere where they can come and they can be accepted for not having a specific hobby or interest. The youth club's the best place to socialise.
It's not a difficult environment to enter.
No, I would hope not. Yeah. I would hope not. I think for a lot of people, coming somewhere new is always difficult. So coming through the Beehive front door could be a really big step for some young people and find it very difficult. My hope is once they do come in and they meet me and they meet other young people and other members of staff, they do feel welcome, they do feel relaxed, and they feel as though this is the place, it's their place, it's a place for young people, and they should feel very comfortable here.
Thank you very much. I hope it all goes well. Wish you well for the future.
That's it.
And I can't have one of those questions that I asked.
Well,
I hope so. I hope the mic caught that.
I know it got
it's
a bit noisy to begin with, but you can increase the volume, but then separate.
Yeah, I can separate levels of it.
I think.
I can actually do it on the camera. I can actually do it on the camera.
No, so is that it? Am I done?
That's it, yeah. Woohoo! I've noticed you have the code of conduct on there, so I'm just going to take a few seconds of that. Just so that can come on and just do.